Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to my channel. So I definitely want to say that we're going to do something today that'll help me out when it comes to watching cricket. So I've done a video on cricket. The first time I've ever watched cricket, never even knew what cricket was. And I took a look at Sachin Tendulkar. He definitely showed me and introduced what cricket was for me. And watching it, you know, I have questions as far as what it, you know, what the rules are, what exactly is going on. But for sure, the first thing I noticed is that it is really interesting. I'm like intrigued by what is going on. I want to know what's going on. So that's what I want to do today. We're going to go ahead and figure out what's going on with cricket, what the rules are for cricket, and just get a little bit more insight on what cricket is. So I want you guys to join me. Let's go ahead and take a look. Alrighty, so we're going to go ahead and look at the rules of cricket. Explain. What is it?
Welcome to the amazing sport of cricket.
Bowling, great delivery, wonderful strike.
Cricket is the second most popular sport in the world and is played in over 120 countries. It is supported by millions of passionate fans of all ages and from all walks of life. They play in the park, on the beach, and even in the street.
It's cool, like the family game, they can play it at home.
Rich or poor, young or old, this ancient 16th
play
century
game
unites and inspires people from all countries and cultures.
Century. Wow.
To the layman, the game can seem a bit complicated, but it's actually quite easy to understand once you grasp the basics.
Okay.
Depending on the format, a game of cricket can last hours, a day, or in the case of test cricket, up to five days.
Five days. What?
The basic rules,
or laws,
cricket, are always the same. Cricket is played on
a grass field
with a specially prepared rectangular playing surface in the center. This is known as the cricket pitch.
Okay.
The pitch is where most of the action takes place. Two teams play the game. Each team has 11 players.
11 players.
To play,
you'll need a bat, a ball,
and three wooden poles called stumps. The captains of each team.
It's funny how when you look at that, like when you take a look at sports and it'll have different names, different meanings for things. You've got the bat. Look at that bat and how it is, the form of it, the shape of it. It's more of like a flat surface. And then you look at bat when it comes to baseball, and that bat is like totally different. It just, I just wanted to point that out because that was interesting to me to see like two same words, two different looks when it comes to two different sports.
The captains of each team flip a coin to decide who will bat first and who will have to field. Each side will have a turn to bat and a turn to bowl. Unlike baseball, each team will generally only bat once in a match. The aim of the game is to score as many runs as you can.
Oh wow, that was an interesting way to hit that.
The team with the most runs at the end of the game
is the winner. Scooped it.
The key players at any time in a cricket match are the bowler, the batsman,
and the
fielders.
Look like he's bowling too.
A bowler,
batter, and fielder.
The bowler will try to outwit the batsman by
bowling.
Look at
how he like threw it. Like, that looks like it hurts. Like,
fast.
Jeez.
Spin.
How do you do that without hurting?
Skillful manipulation of how the ball moves in
look
the
at
air
that.
Or behaves
like
once it bounces
it
on the pitch. The fielders must be alert and agile, ready to react if the ball comes their way. At the top level of the game, fielders are highly athletic to ensure they can save as many runs as possible.
Wow. And you're catching that with no gloves?
The batter.
Like, the sound of the ball and bat sound hard, so I know the ball gotta be hard.
The ball. To score runs, the batter must hit the ball and then run to the other end of the pitch before the fielding team can return the ball.
Is there a limit on runs?
They can run up and down the pitch as many times as they feel they can before the fielding team can get the ball back.
Oh.
Each time the batter completes a length of the pitch, a run is scored against their name. If a batter hits the ball to the boundary of the field, they are awarded 4 runs.
Wow,
this is called a 4.
Points from hitting to the boundary.
The highest scoring shot in cricket is a 6.
That's a little more orthodox and it's gone all the way.
Wow.
A batter can score 6 runs.
Okay, so that's the first sport that I know. I have to point this out. The first sport that I've seen where you can hit it out of bounds or out the boundary and get points for that. So that's very interesting.
By hitting the ball over the boundary rope without the ball touching the ground. The fielding team is trying to get the batter out as quickly as possible to prevent them scoring runs. Batters can be got out in a number of ways. the bowler strikes the stumps directly while bowling. Bowled. Catching the ball in the air before it touches the ground. Caught.
That painful catch.
Or returning the ball to the end of the cricket pitch before the batter can complete their run. Run out. Once the batter is declared out, they have to leave the field and are replaced by the next batter.
So both pitcher run out.
Once all batters are out, the fielding team gets a chance to beat the score set by the first batting team.
Ball in.
One of the most popular forms of cricket is known as 2020 cricket. Introduced in 2003, this is a shorter, adrenaline-fueled version of the game, limited to 120 balls per side, split into groups of six bowls called overs.
Which makes up
20
the 120.
20 overs per side makes up a team's total innings.
Okay.
The limited number of overs means the batsmen have to aggressively
score. So it goes quicker. Runs,
and this makes for a thrilling spectacle.
So that's why that only takes 3 hours to score for that, runs for their as team. They said at the beginning.
A 2020 game is generally completed in about 3 hours, with each inning lasting about 75 minutes.
I want to know what.
This type of cricket is so really popular.
Basically, 2020 lasts 3 hours, so the regular game of cricket must last a day. Like, I still want to know what the heck lasts 5 days. Wow.
And is driving the phenomenal growth of the sport around the world.
Tournament has to be 5 days.
It generally results in a carnival party atmosphere at cricket matches.
Everybody looks excited though.
Now you know
from
what's
all
cricket.
Over. I see all kinds of different flags, all kinds of different individuals. Cricket seems very interesting for sure. Learning and watching this video breaks it down a lot better for me because I didn't know what the position were. I didn't know what the point was, what they were supposed to do, how they gain points. Nothing. So watching this on top of actual watching Sachin Tendulkar, now I know exactly what he was doing, and now as I watch anyone else, I'll know what's going on as well. So I hope this helped you guys out. It sure helped me out, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up if you did, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you guys next time.